What are magnetic fields and how they can be measured? This and more you will find out now. In physics, there are four basic forces: gravitation, the weak nuclear force, the strong nuclear force, and the electromagnetic force. The electromagnetic force can be divided into electric force and magnetic force. Each atom of a material has a magnetic moment. Due to the influence of heat, this moment changes constantly. In ferromagnetic materials, additional coupling forces occur between the electron spins, and these coupling forces work against the heat movement. This leads to the complete alignment of small areas. If the material is now magnetized, the Weiss domains align and the material becomes magnetic. Deactivating the external magnetic field, the material holds a residual magnetization. It is named the remanence of the material. If we now set an opposite field, or if we exceed the Curie temperature of about 600 degrees, the material is demagnetized. Moving charge carriers also generate a magnetic field. If an electric current flows through a copper wire, it is surrounded by a magnetic field. So this field corresponds with the strength of the current. To determine the direction of the magnetic field, we can use the right-hand rule. If the current flows in this direction, the magnetic field is in this direction. Okay, now we know that magnetic fields are either generated by moving charge carriers or they come from magnetizable material. But how we can measure them? One of these three measurement systems is usually used to measure magnetic fields. Squid sensors can measure smallest magnetic fields and are based on the effect of flux quantization in superconducting rings. Due to the extreme sensitivity, these sensors are only used in laboratories for research. Hall sensors are the most commonly used sensors. If a magnetic field acts on a current carrying conductor, the so-called Hall voltage is generated by the Lorentz force. Hall sensors can be used to measure relatively low and strong magnetic fields. Today, we mainly look at the Fluxgate sensor, also called the Förster probe. This probe is capable to measure smallest magnetic fields also under harsh conditions. A Fluxgate magnetometer consists of at least one soft magnetic core. A coil is wound around the core, and this coil is used to drive the core periodically above saturation. Now we receive the resulting signal with a measurement coil. Since we have driven the core beyond full magnetization, it loses its bundling effect and the signal collapses. If now an external magnetic field works on our system, our signal shifts and the core is reaching the saturation earlier. This effect is proportional to the applied magnetic field. For the evaluation, of course, there are many optimizations possible, like the excitation with the pulse or adjusting the coil and core arrangements. For a highly accurate measurement, the probe needs to be calibrated in a special shielded chamber with defined magnetic fields. Now we are ready for measuring smallest magnetic fields, such as which come from the magnetic force of the material. So if you put the material here, we see, oh, there's a signal, so we have a residual field on this material. Or we can measure electrical forces in power lines, such as this probe. So this is a probe with an alternating current in it. And we see a signal which goes up and down because the alternating current, and we see the alternating field. In our next video, I will show you what to consider while measuring magnetic fields and where it is used in practice. If you liked our video, subscribe to our channel and see you next time.